There's an Excel function called INDIRECT, which isn't known by many beginners, and it's definitely underutilized. But it's very useful if you want your sheet to behave dynamically. INDIRECT usually carries only one argument, and that's a cell reference. There is an optional argument where we type true or false. True is the default. If we type false, it means we're using the R1C1 cell reference style. In this tutorial, we'll concentrate on the A1 cell reference style, that's the column first, row next naming convention, just to keep it simple. To help you see what INDIRECT does, take a look at this sheet. Usually in Excel, we know that if we type equals and a cell reference, Excel just copies and returns whatever's in that cell. So in cell A3, we typed A1, and if we went to another cell and typed equals A3, what value would Excel return? Well, it would just copy whatever A3 says, which is A1. But now, what if we use the INDIRECT function instead? Would Excel still return a value of A1? Let's see. We'll type INDIRECT, open parenthesis, A3, close parenthesis. Now it says, today is Monday. So you can see what INDIRECT did there. It acted like a detour sign or middleman. So you understand that, but now you're wondering, why is this useful? We're about to find out. Remember at the outset, we said that INDIRECT is useful when we want our worksheet to behave dynamically. Well, here's an example. On this sheet, I have monthly sales figures of 3 items. Just below, I've set up a query where I can ask for the sum, average, minimum, and maximum sales by type of fruit. We want to be able to change the name of the fruit in B7 and have Excel extract the right values from this dataset and return the results of the calculation. This is where named ranges are helpful. So we've already set up a range called apples, which refers to this group of cells. Let's do the same for mangoes and pears by selecting each range and naming them. Now, we usually use named ranges to make formulas easier to understand, but they're also useful when we use the INDIRECT function because, remember, INDIRECT acts like a detour sign by pointing to a reference. And, after all, named ranges are really references. So we've set up our ranges, and we've typed the word apples in B7 so that Excel interprets that as the range A2 to M2. So if we want to find the sum of the values in the apples range, we'll type equals, sum, open parenthesis, and now we use the INDIRECT function by typing INDIRECT, open parenthesis, B7. And I'll just anchor the reference to B7 here because I'm going to copy this to the cells below. Close parenthesis on the INDIRECT function and close for the sum function. We hit enter, and Excel has calculated the sum of the range that we named apples. We can do the same for mangoes and for pears. So we can just copy this formula to the cells below and change each function name as appropriate. So this is what we mean when we say INDIRECT helps our sheet to behave dynamically. Now let's go back to our original sheet for a second, and let's do something interesting. We go back to this cell where we typed INDIRECT A3, and what would happen if we enclose this cell reference in double quotes when we use the INDIRECT function? Instead of saying today is Monday, it now says A1. What happened here? Well, putting double quotes around the cell reference in the INDIRECT function says to Excel, treat this value as a text string. So what we have now is the same as saying equals A3. That idea will come in handy later. Now let's really roll up our sleeves. We can also use INDIRECT to create dynamic worksheet references. On these sheets, we have sales data for the past 5 years. The sheets are all set up in the same way, which is important, because we're going to write one set of formulas on our query sheet, but the results will change depending on the year we query. So we want to find out the total sales for each item of produce, depending on the year we enter in B1. So as an example, if we wanted to find out the total apple sales for 2017, we'd manually go in and select this range. But now we want to do this without hard coding 2017 into our formula, so that if we type 2016, the figure here will change. To do this, we'll use the indirect function. Let's show you a simple way to process what to do when you have to do this on your own, on the fly. So let's change this hard-coded 2017 with a dynamic reference to cell B1 while telling Excel that it should look for a sheet with that name. Notice the format when Excel refers to sheet names. It's enclosed in single quotes followed by an exclamation mark. Well, if we enter the indirect function here and the open parenthesis, we know that the indirect format is just to enter the cell reference name, which in our case would be B1. So let's replace 2017 with B1, but indirect really only wants to see that reference. All the other characters are extras, and indirect won't know how to handle them. So let's turn them into text by enclosing them within double quotes, which we just learned. So all the extra characters should be enclosed within double quotes. So our single quotation mark has now been surrounded by double quotes. We need a concatenate operator, which is the ampersand sign, another ampersand here, and then more double quotes. We finish everything off with close parentheses for our sum function and hit enter. And now we have the updated figure for 2016 Apple sales. We want the reference to B1 to be anchored or fixed. So let's make that a fixed range by hitting F4 or Control T if you're using Mac. We copy down and we need to change these because mangoes are in row 3 and pears are in row 4. So now our indirect function is helping our worksheet to behave dynamically. This idea and format takes a bit of getting used to, but after you've done it 3 or 4 times, it gets easier. Once you learn the logic of a function, it's better than trying to memorize the format. Why not download the free practice exercise and get comfortable using the indirect function?
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.